Okay, so we are heading towards week four of Tennessee Titans franchise. If you haven't seen the previous episodes, there's a playlist down below. And there were some good games, so I recommend watching the other games down below. Let's go ahead and advance the week to week four against the Colts. We did lose last week against the Las Vegas Raiders. We tried to come back in the game late. Ryan Tannehill cost us the game at the end, which brought our record down to 1-2. And we are last in the division. The Jags are 2-1. The Colts, Texans, and Titans are all 1-2. We have to beat the Colts. We have to beat the Colts. Oh, QB1 check-in. Okay, let's see what he needs. Let's see what he has. Coach, your team has struggled out of the gate so far, and when that happens, a lot of blame is usually placed on the quarterback. Who needs to step up? I'm gonna say Ryan Tannehill. I wanna see him do some more stuff. I think blame is a strong word, but it's a part of the QB when the team's slumping. Everybody's looking. Okay, I was trying to read that. Beat the Colts and have 3+ passing touchdowns with Ryan Tannehill. I think that is doable. I think I could do that against the Colts defense. Especially if they're missing some key pieces on defense. Let's look at if they have any injuries. We do not. And the Colts do not. Okay. Let's look at some free agents that we got. Amani Hooker wants 4 years, 14.6 million. How old is he? 24. That's not, he's not doing that bad this season. Maybe. I'm gonna probably wait to re-sign anybody till later. Let's go ahead and start weekly strategy for this week's game. We have to stop Jonathan Taylor. That is a must. We must stop Jonathan Taylor. Let's go outside. Let's try to stop in the outside runs. On offense, I'm gonna say throw it short. Just, get Ryan Tannehill more comfortable in this game. Just throw some short passes. And then we need 3+ passing, or we need 3+ passing touchdowns. So let's do this one. 2+ passing touchdowns because we need three with Ryan Tannehill. So we'll do that. And yeah, we're good. Let's hope no one gets injured during the training. And defense looks good. Okay, defense is non-injured. Offense, I think we're good. ACL sprain for Nate Davis. That's not good. That's not good. How long is he gonna be out? 1 week. Okay. Okay. One week's fine. Let's go to Indianapolis to play the Colts. We have to win this game. This is a much win divisional game against the Colts. If we lose this game, we're down by.
And coming up, we'll see the workhorse Jonathan Taylor.
Won't be
He's
good.
Coming off a nice showing last week.
Stop Jonathan
racked
Taylor.
Up a lot of yards and reached the end zone once. It's the Colts and the Titans. All that and more coming up next.
We have to win this game.
It's the National Football League. Virginia.
Stuff things off on a positive note. I know we need passing touchdowns from Ryan Tannehill, but we're going to run the ball a lot. Woods, if he blocked, he would have had a touchdown possibly.
Like that start, 14 yards to get him going. Just a terrific run there, Charles, from a running back who is so compact and powerful, and that strength was on display there.
Yeah, this could be a sign of what this defense is in for, because you know all week long the coaches were preaching to the defense, you've got to be able to wrap up against a back like him.
Both
he
of
can
these,
make you
both of these teams have good
technique.
Running backs. So this will be a run-heavy game. First and 10. Now it's Tannehill. Oh, so X-late.
Protection just broke down.
Let's go. You've got to have that leverage, don't you? There is something about one man wins in the running game for offensive defense. It's essentially the same thing. It's protection.
I'm looking at Burks or Wood. Good defense drive. Good defense.
Numbers pretty solid. Does he continue that?
I think so, because when you come out of the gate this strong, that means that you have planned for it and you like the results that you're getting. So I wouldn't have any doubt that
how but I have to lock the ball and be toward the right side of the field kind of play. Yeah, Henry, get off me. Get off of King Henry.
The Titans get 14 yards there.
I think get off King Henry run.
If you start something what went wrong last week, Charles, in their loss, had nothing to do with the brain game.
I'm going to block him.
You have to set yourself as a team. Don't go away from the That's not the reason the game is lost. Running the football, third time, you did consistently.
Okay, I'm okay with that. Nice. That's what
17 yards on his first catch of the game. It's a first down.
Let's keep going. Throw you up offense. Touchdown Woods! That's a nice drive. I like that drive. I'm watching a lot.
And the Titans are on the board first here this afternoon. This is a crew that come out flat their last two games. Both
we need a win.
But just judging by the energy level, they look different here early, and that touchdown shows how.
Yeah, it seems to me that touchdown gets them off the treadmill. As you know, you've been on the treadmill. I've seen you work out. You go forever and ever.
That's a good drive. Let's keep going. Let's have the defense stop their offense. Stop dropping Taylor.
But they can get there.
And let's keep this ball moving. Let's keep this ball moving.
Stick game, but I think when it comes within your division like this, it's a measuring stick game with a little extra injury.
I would agree with that totally.
Oh, I was trying to jump that one.
Ready for me. This game is situated because at this stage of the season, it has that little extra juice, but at the same time, it's not a make or break if this were, let's say, week 15, 16.
Hit him! Oh, you got to throw the ball away. We're not getting enough pressure on the QB. We need more pressure on the QB. Okay, we stopped the short yard. I'll take it. Take it. Let's go. Keep doing that. Let's go. They're not running it as much as I thought they're gonna run it. That probably should have been my spot. You gotta stop my companion.
Which essentially gave him seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they can let a tackler through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
On second and 12, Ryan.
Pick.
This is going to be intercepted. Picked up by
Amari Hooker. Getting the offensive line. Look.
Definitely not the ideal time.
least a field as he was throwing the ball up, it was up for grabs. Now,
pressure's on defensively to prevent that pick from turning into points for the other side.
Us who came up with it.
Derrick Henry trots back out there and gets ready to go. A good job in the passing game, decent job in the running game, but really they've been more effective through the air. We'll see if that shifts at all as this goes on.
That's great. Dang it, I threw it straight. I wasn't hit. I was trying to get it to B. I hit the wrong hit Y by mistake. This is... Ryan Tannehill's all trend is not great. As soon as they said that, they gave up first down.
Try. This is an easy one, 23 yarder. Blankenship's kick is good.
say, yes, Kenny will do a pick. I hit the wrong receiver, so it's my bad. It's the wrong button. Okay. Let's not throw a pick this time. How about that? Derrick Henry, great blocking. First down.
Maybe they get to it in a little bit different way, because after you throw an interception, you want to make sure you keep your quarterback's confidence high. So maybe give him a couple easy throws that he can complete, and then get to the running game.
Pretty paid to head it back to the locker room. Did I throw it too? I guess I threw it too late.
Stopping with 16 seconds to go in half number one.
down.
This will be play number 7 on the drive. 3rd and a yard. Throwing again.
Finally, something's good on defense.
Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half. Moved back to the 10. They'll try on 2nd and goal here. From the shotgun, Ryan.
Pick it! How do we keep dropping picks?
Defensively get the sack on 1st and goal.
Do we have Butterfingers with hands? Reeves should have had 3 or 4 picks this game. We should have had 3 or 4 picks this game.
Eager to get back to this week 4 matchup, we won't put up a fight. Welcome back, halftime over. We are.
This is the thing. I want to put in Malik Willis, but I had a 3 passing touchdown game scenario.
So here are the Colts to take over. They lost 2 straight coming in, but good news for them right now, they got the lead and the football. Ryan and the Colts getting set here, 1st and 10, at their own 25-yard line. They'll start with a gifted team. Not much to speak of. A 1-yard gain up to the 26. The run only got a yard here, 2nd and 9. An extra defensive back out there for the Titans now here for 3rd down.
How did I miss him? How did he miss him? Of course. Only we can give up 19 yards on a running play.
Down. Now it's Ryan.
gonna be a long loop though. First and 10, 10.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run.
We stopped him. Let's go. And it's, of course, the goal. Oh. Well, I dropped the pick, but it was fourth down, so it's fine. Let's not throw a pick, Tannehill. That's his great save. That's a great save. Robert Woods injured. Okay. So that sucks.
Time is called. Looks like a member of the Titans in some discomfort out there. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Again, it's in. That is the play of the game. Now Bullock to add the extra point. And this puts him on top by a penny. It's 14-13. So not only the cough up, but then the pickup on the other side, the scoop, and the score the other way.
Great job, defense. Yes, we dropped like 5 interceptions. we could have had. But we needed it most. We got a forced fumble and a touchdown. We got 7 minutes and 40 seconds. By Simmons.
Jeffrey Simmons that time who got in to record the sack. Throwing on second and long. Ryan. He'll take a shot downfield for Pittman. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there. Ready, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
7 minutes left. We've got to keep this lead.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And now he'll fire deep downfield for James. And able to connect. Incomplete. I'll give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
I thought he had him.
Sanchez on to punt here as he sends this one away. This is fielded at the 27. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
And an offensive lineman's down.
During that run, an injury here. We got one of those big blockers in some discomfort. Well, now they're going to come out and take a look at this injury, and we'll be back in a moment. So they go from 142-yard line to the other as they come up now first and 10. Tannehill able to find Henry out of the backfield. And he'll be out just a
four interceptions. He's 10 for 16 with four interceptions.
And I believe that'll be enough for another first down.
I guess you could say one or two of them are on me, but the other two are on Ryan Tannehill.
Yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. 6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four. Tannehill gonna turn and give this to Henry. A few times here today. This one's not gonna go anywhere.
I see if I can find Traylon Burks up the middle.
And once in 4 tries. This is third and four.
How? Am I playing Madden wrong? Tell me, am I playing Madden wrong? He was wide, stinking open. I threw it on a line. How?
60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out of the shadow here on the goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again, so it's not picking up a couple of first downs.
That was definitely right, Tannehill. I threw a perfect ball to the turn, but... and he got picked.
On second and one, Ryan gets his target to tight end Riley Collins.
When we try to pick the ball off, we either drop it.
So signs of life and what's been a tough offense in this second half. Here's
first and ten.
Running straight ahead, Taylor. And a short pick up to about the 27. It'll be
second. David Long's now injured.
Because on that last run, it looks like he
all Maddie gives me are picks and injuries.
Second and six. And not a lot doing there as he'll get up to about the 28-yard line. Only a yard there on the keeper, and that's going to
why are you running it with Matt Ryan?
Here's Ryan.
Oh my God. God, these Colts are driving me nuts. Well, Madden's driving me nuts because they're making me throw like 5 picks. It's not even on me. One of them, maybe two of them, are my fault. The other 3 are his. Harold Landry with a sack.
The sack by Harold Landry, the former Boston College Eagle. Oh,
Why?
And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. Just a 1 yard loss that time, but that's not what they needed. Now they're dealing with a third and long. Fourth quarter, 2 minutes on the clock in a tight 1 point game. So the Colts in possession of the football as we get you reset. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Here's Ryan to throw.
That was right there.
That's James. And they're going to get this up to midfield. The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it prior to what will be an important fourth down.
Ready!
Are you kidding me? How did he catch that one? I went straight to my guy. Okay, that's what it is. Madden doesn't want me to win. Thank you. They missed. What?
It's short and no good. And that'll keep this a 1 point game. And that one, my goodness, that was almost too easy.
Yeah, you knock out too many attempts shorter than that one. And I don't think this was
blocked. Oh, my God.
That's about as bad a miss as you can have.
Oh, my God. How can you miss that? We're coming out of here with a win.
Yep.
Tannehill can 5 interceptions. And we're going to win this game.
As the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. Second and 11 for the 19. A shotgun handoff to Henry. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a game of 6. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talking over on their respective sidelines, we take a break.
What an awful field goal attempt. But I don't know how he pulled this W off. It wasn't Ryan Tannehill. He would have cost us the game.
Losing the game is one thing. Getting shut out in the second half, that's a surprise.
It's our defense. Our defense stood up when we needed the most.
500 start as the win gets them back to 2-2. And they'll get another road date next week when they take on Washington.
Yeah, because this can't happen anymore. You can't be throwing 5 interceptions. Okay, I admit, one of the 2 interceptions are all my bad. But all 5 of them are not on me. I did not throw all 5 of those picks. Ryan Tannehill threw 3 of those by himself. I can take blame for 2 of them. But 3 of them, no. That's all him. But 2 of them, I'll take blame for 2 of them. One of them, I hit the wrong button. And then the other one was just a bad pass. I mean, Robert Woods got a touchdown. 2 for 8 and a touchdown. Brooks got some decent amount of yards. Kevin Byard literally gave us the win. Wow. What a game. I mean, I'm upset for Ryan Tannehill. He should not have thrown 5 interceptions. But what a great defensive game. We won by the defense. The defense won us the game. I mean, like they say, defense wins championships. We won against our division rivals, the Indianapolis Colts, 14-13. What a game. I know Ryan Tannehill didn't get his 3 touchdowns. I didn't have the game I set out to have, but personal achievements are secondary to getting the win, and we accomplished that this week. Well, Ryan Tannehill, you flat out sucked this game. It's a great attitude to have, especially as one of the leaders of this team. Keep preaching that to the team, and we're going to go for it. Well, for your understanding, Ryan Tannehill, you sucked. Ryan Tannehill will have +5 medium and deep throw accuracy for the next game. That's good, because he needs it. He needs that. Well, that's going to wrap up this game. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe. And on the next week, we'll be facing the Washington Commanders, which is my favorite team. And, make sure to like, comment, subscribe. And see you on week 5.